Win the incredible Steigercraft, Evinrude, Lowrance Grand Prize Boat Package, and more in the Fisherman's 2018 Dream Boat Fishing Challenge. Get the details at thefisherman.com.
Hey there, Toby Lipinski for the New England edition of Fisherman Magazine with this week's web video fishing forecast for New England. We got a lot going on this holiday week with great catches on all sorts of species, including sharks, fluke, black sea bass, and some really big striped bass to 60 pounds. 4th of July holiday week often brings with us some really good fishing, and this year is no different. But before I get to the details on those catches for you, I want to direct you to a video we just posted at thefisherman.com with Al Steiger of Steiger Boats. Now in this video, he discusses not only some of the history behind his great boat builds, but he also discusses the reintroduction of a classic center console platform, the expansion of motor options for 2018 and future models of the Steigercraft, and some all-important details on the boat, which is going to be won by a lucky Fisherman Magazine reader in this year's Dream Boat Challenge, that sweet 23-foot DV Miami boat. It is awesome. All right, well, let's see. As I noted just a moment ago, there's a great variety of action taking place across southern New England right now with really just about every species producing good bites. We've got the annual Niantic Shark Week tournament going on right now. It's run by the guys from J&B Tackle over Niantic, and they've had some solid entries, including a 307-pound Mako landed by the crew of the Matora. This tournament runs through this weekend, July 8th, so there's still time to get on the leaderboard. Let's see, boats heading out into Buzzards Bay, Block Island Sound, and Long Island Sound, so pretty much everywhere with Dormack, Fluke, or Humpback Seabass on their sights have been having really little trouble finding fish. Heard from Captain Chris at Double Trouble Sport Fishing in Westerly over the weekend. He sent me some pictures of a nice catch of black seabass that he made with one of his charters, and I'm getting word of really easy limits on seabass to 5+ pounds. And they're both being caught as bycatch by anglers targeting other bottom species, as well as when they make the switch or target them specifically. Now you just gotta remind you, be sure to weigh in those big humpbacks as they are one of the 8 eligible Dreamboat species for your chance to win that Steigercraft 23-foot DV Miami boat. Also included on the eligible species, we've got scup, we've got weakfish, blackfish, bluefish, mahi, sea robin, and fluke. So pretty much everything covered right there for you. It's your chance to win that awesome boat. And speaking of fluke, the action remains very good. Waters kind of the string from Montauk to Block Island up on over to Nantucket for those larger fish. Sort of that channel direction there is getting the bigger fish. And there's plenty of sort of those just keepers to about 5-pound class of fish being found on the inshore grounds along that whole stretch. A good friend of mine, Joe D'Agostino of Joe Bags Tackle, he went fishing recently out off of Nantucket, and he was using his 1/2 to 1 ounce fluky and gulpy jigs that he makes, and he rigged them behind some heavy bank sinkers on three-way rigs, and he limited out on big fluke to 8+ pounds. He said the fishing was outstanding with limits all around the boat. Now, if you'd like to take a look at this fishery, see how to get in on it, see what it's all about, give a read to the article, which appears in the July edition of the Fisherman Magazine, written by Captain Scott Newell. The waters off Nantucket are truly the land of doormats here up in New England, and they might just land you on the Dreamboat leaderboard, as that area has done for so many fishermen subscribers over the years. Excuse me. And let's see, last but certainly not least, there was a run of large striped bass this week with fish in excess of 50 pounds landed all over the region. We had fish 50s in the canal, off of Block Island, Eastern Long Island Sound. First up, Red Top Sporting Goods weighed in a 50.75 pound 51 inch bass that was landed early Sunday morning in the canal. The bite up there was, it sounded like it was okay last week. Overall, it got better going into the weekend, and next week's new moon tide should continue with some great action and high hopes for canal anglers. And then, aboard the Blackhawk sailing out of Niantic, Connecticut, Captain Greg, he's really been dialed in on a body of large striped bass for the better part of a week. And originally, he started off working these schools of bass, three-weighing bucktails, doing really good on fish to that mid-30-pound class. And they gave it a shot. They switched over to live eels, and it produced big time. Saturday night's trip saw a full boat limit to 40-plus pounds. And they did their daytime porgy trip, as they do every day, and went right back out Sunday night and got back on the fish. And they topped out Sunday night. Biggest fish of the trip was a 50-pound fish. But the largest of the large in local waters so far was caught early Saturday night when Connecticut angler Joe Aponowicz dropped a live eel down off his friend Dan Pawanski's boat, and he hooked into a massive striped bass. When it was landed, the fish bottomed out the 50-pound scale that they put it on. So they put on a 60-pound boga. It bottomed that out on the water there just after 9 p.m. when it was caught. By the time they got it back in the next morning to weigh in at Fishing Factory 3, they did try to release it. They were unable to, so they harvested the fish. They brought it into Fishing Factory 3 Sunday morning when Andrew opened up. And at that point, you know, 10 plus hours later, had an official weight of 59.45 pounds. Fish measured 53 inches, had a massive 31.25 inch girth. It only had a single skate in its belly, so that fish was hungry. I can only imagine if it had been loading up on some bunker what that would have done, but no matter what, that is an awesome catch. Congrats to Joe and all the guys on the boat that night. All right, well, there you have it. I am Toby Lipinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman Magazine, wishing you tight lines if you head out onto the water this holiday week or weekend.
Win the incredible Steigercraft, Evinrude, Lowrance Grand Prize Boat Package, and more in the Fisherman's 2018 Dream Boat Fishing Challenge. Get the details at thefisherman.com.